Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? 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 Guess who's back?
Yes, yes, we're back. We're back. Hold on a minute. Just wait. Let's set you up right about here, maybe. What do you think? Is that okay? Does that come in? I have no clue. I'm just putting the camera on a stand and pointing and shooting and hope it works. Okay, we're back. And as you can tell, we're buzzed up on a little bit of coffee. What else is new, right? Flying through the air. What do you call that? That intro? Flying through the air coffee character. French vanilla. She's wonderful. That's okay. French, white girl, Asian girl. I don't care. I take them all. We'll give them all a tryout. Yeah. You know what? In my world, I say turn them upside down, naked, and they all look like sisters. See what happens when you feed coffee with me? Or have coffee with me and feed me coffee? I start going crazy. Actually, I'm on low sleep mode. I did a 14-hour shift yesterday. Hour and a half to drive to the city and an hour and a half to drive back. We carpooled, right? I go with the others. And then the rest of the 10-hour was all doing inventory. So yeah, it was, that would make 11 hours. 11 and 3, 14. Yeah, it was from 5 in the morning and we got back at 8 o'clock-ish. Today, it was rough getting up this morning. But now, yeah, I just inject myself with coffee and away I go. So I'm getting a little delirious, as you can see. No builds today. I would like to get some time building because things are looking pretty neat, actually. But yeah, as you saw in the video, we're doing an unboxing. I'll show you that. And I'll tell you the reason why I'm doing this unboxing today in this video and review of this kit. And the reason why I'm building this kit. So, back at the beginning of this year, January, the first weekend of January, I went to Vancouver. This model kit here. I bought the AAR CUDA. Is this camera rolling? Did I even press the button? I'm probably talking. And, oh yeah, it is. Good thing. Probably talking to camera that's not running. See how bad we are? Wow. Oh, what the fuck, Chuck? So I bought the AAR CUDA kit. I saw another kit I wanted to buy. The Haulaway Hauler, or Haulaway Trailer, that I saw at the hobby shop. And I didn't want to haul it all the way back to the island here, so I found a place in town that actually had this model kit for $3 cheaper. So I thought, hey, I'm gonna support local. I'll just pick it up in town and I don't have to ship it with me all the way back. So that's what we got. Here's where I got it. Whoops, sorry about that. This and that shop, it's a small little kind of consignment collector's place. They actually have a few different model kits there. So you can see they had the Surf Wagon, the Chevelle Wagon. That is pretty cool. $39.99 these were all new, still wrapped. So that kit was $39.99. Look at this. You're not going to believe this kit. The Pinto is $47 Canadian. Holy crap, buddy. You're a little bit high on that. It's not a rare kit. It's a repop. They had the 65 Galaxy, the Jolly Green Gasser kit. That is a cool kit, actually. I like the square bodied, I guess is what you call it, Galaxies, $42.99. And they also had the Duster kit. Look at that, $39.99. It's still there as far as I'm aware of. I could go and get another Duster. 65 Cornet, $39.99. So that's what they got. But I was looking at this, the Haulaway Hauler, and $54. So it's a couple bucks cheaper than my favorite hobby shop. So that's what we're gonna review today. So let's put you back up on the shelf. Don't mind my blah blah moving you around. that's what we're going to do. We're eventually going to review this. But first, I need glasses because I can't see. The reason why I'm doing the Haulaway trailer. Sorry, excuse my French vanilla. Speaking of that, let's get jacked up. Not jacked off. Jacked up. You'll see a theme here. 70 CUDA, 70 Duster, which technically is really a 71 Duster, but I'm calling it a 70 Duster that I'm currently doing. Where is it? This kid here. So we got the Duster and the CUDA. 1970 cars. I have a 70 Charger. I have a 70 Superbird. Guess what? We're doing a 70s dealership hauling theme. That's what it is. And I mentioned this before. Yeah, see, I did pay $54.99. I don't know. Lights on it. You can't see it. So that is what we're going to do on that coming up eventually. But we got to finish the Duster first. The Duster is coming along. I'm pointing the camera who knows where as I bend over. And this kit. I'm adding this. It's all 125ths I got. The CUDA is 125th, the Duster is 125th, and the Johan Superbird is going on there, 125th. So I got three cars. I'll have to pick two more. I might do two Dusters, and I might do, I don't know what else, maybe the Charger, who knows, we'll see what becomes. We're not 100% sure yet. But let's get this organ set up. I'll unbox it, cut it open, and you'll see all that good stuff. Now that I've done a lot of blah 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 and whatever. Yeah, well, you know what? Couple more sips. And I'll blah 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 you guys' ear off. It's my third coffee today. Usually I'm a two coffee a day person. Once in a while, three coffees. And today is one of them because I was pretty tired this morning. Getting up at, what, 6:30-ish? Wow, it's too freaking early for this cat. And I'm probably talking too quiet. I have to up my voice so you guys can hear me. So anyways, yeah, okay, shut it, Chuck, for now. That's right, shut it, and just get to unboxing this thing. So we're going to try this view, and I don't know how it's going to come in. So let's open this baby up there, kids. Is it coming in? Oh yeah, checking the camera as I'm cutting, and I'll probably lob a finger off, not paying attention, but I think this view will suffice for substandard Chuck's video channel, video review of this wonderful trailer. How about we just zoom in just a hair? How's that? Maybe, maybe not. Put it, you guys is more in focus, something like that. Yeah, let's see. Let's see what happens. This is an exciting project, actually. It's going to be a pretty cool project. Now, the next thing I'll have to do is find a truck to tow this trailer with. I got the Mack truck. I like that. Maybe that's okay. It's got to be an old school. Or the auto car, I'm thinking. One of those two units is probably what I will use, I think. So, first things first. Look at this chrome. I like it. Chrome rims, not bad. It's going to take some blackening, some weathering maybe type of thing, and maybe some better lighting. How's that? Is that lighting better? I'm going to put it right on the, hang it off the camera, maybe, kind of, sort of. I just might get a little bit of light glare, that's all, off of this. Maybe I'm too bright. That's okay. Sorry, as I do things on the fly here. But so far, no flashing. Chrome looks fairly reasonable. I guess we can open it up for you guys. You guys are special. So yeah, it's a bit too toyish chrome, as they say. So that's going to have to do some blackening and darkening up and making it look like it's been driven. Tires, might as well open it up. We're going to be used. Wow, that's kind of cool. I like it. Make sure I got this in the video. I don't like that it has no lettering. I wish it had, you know, Goodyear or whatever kind of tires on the side of these. Maybe recaps, who knows, being an old unit. Yeah, it looks like a lot of basic flat parts. Holy crap. I don't know much about trucks and semis and haulers, but we can give you an overview of the quality of the finish. So it doesn't look like a lot of parts here. There's some of the ramp. So that's kind of cool. Just one big flat plastic piece. There's the hydraulic cylinders for the back lift gate. That's what it looks like. That's interesting. That's kind of cool. Another piece of flat plastic with some... At least this you can sand off easy to paint it. You don't have to grind it off. So there's another piece of flat trailer section. Maybe that's the back lift. I'm wondering. I'm not sure. Here we go. Some more ramp stuff. A lot of ramp stuff here. We'll be doing lots of ramp painting. So I'm going to have to do some research when I build this on... the looks of these things way back. Did I say it already? This possible. I heard rumors that this truck was modeled after a 1950s hauler or 1960s, so that could be. I'm not sure. So yeah, nothing too fancy. A little bit of flash, but nothing. You know what? It's just flash. It'll cut off. There's the springs a little bit. This is a very old kit. Oh, is that a jack? Oh no, the stands. For the hauler trailer. So where was I going? Yeah, this has been rebuilt. This has been repopped quite a few times, this kit, is my understanding. So I don't know if I have to open this even, but we will anyways, just because we might be substandard, but we don't want to do half-assed. We might as well do full-ass job. Very flat pieces of styrene. Very flat. Look at, my God, that gets no basicer than that, eh? That's pretty basic. Rivets. Do we have to paint all the rivets? I don't even know what color I'm going yet. Again, that's going to have to be a bit of research there. There's the back wheel wells. Yeah, pretty basic, pretty basic. Lots of coloring. So that'll be something new for me, doing weathering, coloring, or kind of semi-weathering. Another piece of the bottom of the trailer, maybe. This looks like... Oh, no, that's the bottom. The other one was a top. So this is the bottom where the axle goes, da-da-da. So very interesting kit, my friends. Very interesting. Nothing very exciting, actually. There's some lights. Oh, wow, look at the lenses. The yellow lenses. I've never seen that before. You guys who've built trailers and trucks before, have you guys had yellow lenses? Wow, why can't normal car model kits have amber lenses like that? Holy shitballs, that's fantastic. And instructions, Haulaway Hauler, very old school, old style instructions, like right out of the 60s, 70s. Wow, this is kind of cool. Very basic assembly for the rims. There's the front support stands that I mentioned. The I-beam axle. Wow, you get no simpler than that. Holy. Look at this. That's it. Maybe I should get a little ways away so you can see all of it. That's it. That's all there is to this kit. $54 for $1 worth of plastic. Maybe $1 for the box. Incredible. They make good money off of this because it's been redone a few times. Will I use this? I don't know. I have to be careful opening that because I could end up cutting it or ripping it, knowing my luck. So does it say city transport? I don't know what we're gonna do for deckling. Should talk to Mike. How much will you send decals to me for? You give me a good deal last time, deal I couldn't refuse, but this time maybe 10, 20 bucks, I don't know. Could have Mopar City or something on it, Twister City. I don't know, Auto World's not bad, that might be an okay decal to use, the Auto World. City Transport, I don't think that'll go on. So I don't know if I'll even be using any decals on the back, I'm not sure. It's the semi-cab that I'm more... concerned about doing deckling. Oh yeah, it says City Cab right there. Does it have it on here? On the truck? City Cab Leasing. Yeah, it does. Look it. So on your truck, you can put the City Cab releasing company on the door. That's a good idea. And AMT. That'd be good on a race car or something. AMT. City car leasing. Or you could just put city on it and then have city car leasing on the truck and just city cut the red and put it up there, city transport. I don't know, we'll see. That's a long way away. Anyways, my friends, you know what? Let's end this. Even though it's raining out, we're gonna end this by going for a bike ride. I gotta get out and get some fresh air. It's my last day of work, my last day off. I gotta go back to work tomorrow. Only work 3 days a week this week, so I love it. I get 4 days to do whatever, do some modeling, do some bike riding, stuff like that. Anyways, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Cheers, my friends. Thanks for chucking out today's video. Unboxing. I still have another, maybe two more unboxings, I think. I do. I have some older kits that I haven't opened up yet. GTX and a charger and something else, I think-ish. So stay tuned for that. Next will be the duster build. We're going to go tonight and finish some more stuff on that. So cheers until then. Yeah, stay awesome. Let's go.